Good morning, Tamina Khan is here in TK Maths is Fun. In today's video, I will explain to you a concept of probability, which is a part of the syllabus of A-level Mathematics S1. So the question I picked up is from June 19, variant 6 to question number 5. So before we begin, you can see on the top my website address, tkmaths.com, and blog address, tkmathsisfun.blogspot.com. Do visit it. You will find many useful information there and online help on particular questions or topic or complete syllabus. You can also register for it. So let's begin with the question. So this question I have picked up because it is covering many concepts like tree diagram, then how to find mean, drawing probability distribution table, and then conditional probability also. So this question will help to learn a lot. So I will do one part at a time. So it is about Mariam has 7 sweets in a tin, okay? And 6 are toffees and 1 is a chocolate. She chooses one sweet at random and takes it out. Now her friends add 3 chocolates to the tin. Then Mariam takes another. So you see a total number of sweets are reducing once she take out, and when friends add into the tin, then again number of chocolate, oh, sweets increase. So let's begin with the question. So first part is saying draw a fully labeled tree diagram. Now the information we have is one time when total sweets are 7. Okay, so first part we will do at a time. This is not a complete tree diagram, it is just for your understanding. So first time when she is drawing from the tin which has 7 sweets, out of which 6 are toffees and 1 is chocolate. The probability of picking up toffee is 6 out of 7 and chocolate is 1 out of 7. So this is the draw of one time. Now once she has drawn, for example, she has drawn toffee, then now there are only 5 toffees. And if she has picked up chocolate, then now there is only no chocolate because it was only 1. So what happened at that time? The friends add in the box 3 more chocolates. So now because one sweet has gone from here, so total are 6 now out of 7 and 3 more are added into it. So now total are 9, but condition is different. What is the condition? If toffee has gone first time, if she has taken toffee out, so now there are 5 toffees, okay, and 1 chocolate and plus 3 more chocolates. So now there are 5 toffees and 4 chocolates, okay, 5 toffees and 4 chocolates. If first time toffee has taken out, or if chocolate has been taken out first time, then now definitely 6 toffees are there as it is, and friend will add 3 more chocolates. So now there are 3 chocolates, 6 toffee. So let's see the chances of drawing it second time. Now if you see here, let's do one at a time. So for example, first time she has taken toffee, we have seen the probability here. Now, second time when she is drawing from the box, total are 9 now. Total sweets are now 9. And altogether there are 5 toffees because 6 were there, 1 is taken out. So now only 5 are left there. Whereas, if you see the chocolate, second time if she is drawing chocolate and first time toffee has been taken out, so now she has 4 chocolates there, because 1 was previously there and 3 friends added. So altogether 4 chocolates. So the probability of drawing chocolate second time is 4 over 9. And here, if the first time was chocolate out from here, then toffees are 6 as it is. So second time the chances are 6 out of 9 for toffees. Whereas if the first time the chocolate is out, then we have 0 here, but friend added 3 more. So altogether there are 3 chocolates. So 3 out of 9. So this is your tree diagram which you will label and show to the examiner. This is, I have explained you here. You don't need to do that part only. Okay. Now draw up the probability distribution table for the number of toffees taken out. Now we have done this in S1, right? This topic, probability distribution table. So if we look at the tree diagram which we have just drawn, in this case, there were 2 toffees taken out. In this case, one toffee, one chocolate. So I am talking about number of toffees taken out, because we have to draw probability distribution table for the number of toffees. So in this case, one toffee, one chocolate. In this case, again, one chocolate, one toffee. So one toffee. And here both are chocolates, so zero toffees. So random variable will be 0, 1, and 2. Because in probability distribution table, you mention number of variables. So the number of toffees which can be taken out are either 0 or 1 or 2. And that we can understand from here, from this tree diagram very well. And X is representing number of toffees taken. Okay. So now we have to write probability. How we are writing it? Look at this. When there are 0 toffees, it means both time chocolates were taken out. Right? CC. And what is the probability of chocolate? First time 1 over 7, second time 3 over 9. So you will multiply and you will get 1 over 21 answer, the probability. Similarly, now what is the probability of taking toffee only one time? There are two cases, toffee chocolate, chocolate toffee. So this is what you will multiply here. You see, chocolate toffee, 1 over 7 into 6 over 9, or 6 over 7 into 4 over 9. So you will consider both the cases, because both these are representing one toffee. And then you will add up the result. So this is 10 over 21. Now the last random variable is that two toffees are taken out. So it is about this tree, this branch. So 6 over 7 into 5 over 9. So this is how you will complete your probability distribution table with the help of the tree diagram. Third part of the question is saying, find the mean number of toffees taken. Now we know from S1 that when we have a probability distribution table, the formula for the mean is X multiplied by probability, random variable multiplied by probability. So we write it as sigma X times probability. So you will write 0 multiplied by this, plus 1 multiplied by this, plus 2 multiplied by this. So you will get the answer 10 over 7, or if you have to write answer in 3 significant figure, you can write 1.43. So let's see the last part. You can do the calculation on your own to figure it out. Last part is about conditional probability. How? See here. Find the probability that the first sweet taken is a chocolate, given that the second sweet taken is a toffee. Right? So now I am seeing the tree diagram again. Now what question is saying? You have to find the probability such that the first time sweet taken is a chocolate, but condition is second time it is toffee. So there are two possibilities, because I'm saying given that. So second time toffee, it means I'm talking about this case, and let me change the color. So I'm talking about this case and this case. So this case is coming first time toffee, second time toffee. Whenever you say in conditional probability given, it means all those conditions from the condition when toffee was second choice. I mean, in the second pickup, the toffee was picked up. And first time it could be toffee or it could be chocolate. So this is your given that. Out of this, what is the probability that first time it was chocolate? So when you will write conditional probability, it means all the cases when toffee was picked up at the second time. It was this one and this one I have written here. Out of these cases, what is the probability that first time it was chocolate and second time it was toffee? So I am simply multiplying this probability along the branch, this probability along this branch. You can see 1 over 7 into 6 over 9. And then I'm plugging in the value here. T is 2 over 21. And this plus this will give me the answer 1 over 6. So simply you are substituting the values and you are calculating it carefully. So I hope it makes sense to you and you understood. If you liked it, please press the like and subscribe button. Do give your comments. They are a source of encouragement. Do share it with your friends. Thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.